let's talk about commercial and industrial transportation. You know, the tractor industry. Tractor industry is obviously in our country, the demand is driven by good monsoons and by good, harvest and crops and things like that. But at the same time, we've seen climate has been playing havoc. We've had locust infestation, which has happened in this year in such a dramatic manner that it's kind of eaten away a lot of crops. There was, of course, a lot of destruction. So on one side, there is a climatic factor which is playing a role in the growth of the commercial and the industrial transportation sector. And at the same time, India is a huge country. We still, we are told by the government that we still need to feed so many people and we have stock for the next 1 year and 2 years. They keep publishing these reports and records. But having said that, from your analysis, have you actually seen that there is a similar kind of opportunity also in the commercial and the industrial space, the trucks? And of course, we sort of exclude this year and this 6 month period from April to September, where everything was in a little bit of a, limbo. But having said that, tractor market and the truck market. You're on mute, Sachin.
Yeah, sorry. Let me start with the tractor first. So let's say when you look at both the tractor as well as you rightly put, it's more dependent on monsoon. This is how the data suggests. So that's quite an accurate observation that you have. So both the tractor and the CV industry are quite cyclical because there is an underlying economics attached to it. So it's not that just the mobility, but there is an underlying economics also attached to it. So tractor, our observation for last 20-25 year industry and even as recent as last 5 years, our observation is it's a underlying 6-7% CAGR industry. Now this is keeping in mind how much. So if you recollect, India is quite a scatteredly hold land banks, right? So on an average, people hold, let's say, a 3 acre kind of land bank. So if you increase that to 6-6.5, then your ability to buy more tractor goes up. But somewhere, maybe we have done this exercise a year and a half back, and which is what was suggesting that even considering the 3 acre and considering the level of income, we are yet to do a right level of penetration, which is required, and there is still a lot more room to grow. And again, our calculation suggests that as promised and as been seen even especially this year, as your income grows in this particular bucket, the level of penetration can further go up, and which is where you can see sustained 6-7% volume growth as far as tractor is concerned. And this is our observation that let's say FY20 was a degrowth, and before that 3 year was a consistent growth. This year again, despite all the rest of the subsegments are going to see a degrowth, this industry, the way we have seen, the way it is panning out, looks like this could be just the tractor piece could be a growth industry this year. So it's a steady state industry, especially this we can comfortably also say, because the water reservoir level from the basically the reservoir levels are quite comfortable at the India level, and which is where there's some sort of comfort could come. Now coming to the CV industry, so CV has been a quite cyclical industry. Again, it's a 7-8% volume growth industry. Again, this is a 20-25 year observation and as recent, but the cycles here in the CV industry are quite sharp. So our observation for last 4 or 5 cycles, basically over a period of last 25 years, clearly suggests that this industry grows in a phase of 3-4 years and then suddenly it collapses. So let's say last year you sold 100, over a period of next 2 years, you will decline by 25% and you will become 50. And then again, you start to grow back. And maybe at year 3 or year 4, you reach to the level of, let's say, 120, 130 volume. So this is an underlying. So when I'm saying underlying growth, there is a volume growth which keeps happening. But then you see the cycle, 100 becoming 50, 50 becoming 120. That is the kind of cycle. So it's more cyclical in nature, and which is where you will see that these companies' profitability also react in that way. सो जस्ट अज्यूम के आपने बिजनेस बनाया है 100 वॉल्यूम के लिए, उस हिसाब से आप एम्प्लॉयज को पैसा भी दे रहे हो, सैलरी दे रहे हो, सारे फिक्स खर्चे हैं, बट सडनली आपकी वॉल्यूम कम हो गई तो आपके लॉसेस भी आने शुरू हो जाते हैं. सिमिलरली व्हेन यू गो बैक टू 120, द सैलरी कॉस्ट, द फिक्स कॉस्ट रिमेन द सेम, बट द प्रॉफिट रियली जंप्स अप, राइट? सो दिस इज द नेचर ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री. इट्स मोर साइक्लिकल, बट अंडरलाइंग ग्रोथ इज देयर. बट अगेन, if you see India roaring back, this is an observation for the last couple of years, despite India not performing, if I were to take that liberty and say that we have not done to the optimal level we should have grown, GDP growth should have been much better. I'm quite confident about this subject that as we pick up on this, the entire GDP growth, this industry could really, really do much better than what it is. Just to give you some fact, last year only, we have seen that FY20 from the peak of FY19, this industry has already declined by close to 47%. On top of that, whatever number you see, so there is a complete collapse in the volume in the industry, which is likely to go up in coming years. So I'm just saying that there is this short-term thing which will really start to kick up. But on top of that, you should also see a sustained longer-term growth in this industry.
Yes, absolutely. Fabulous. So what's very clear, everyone, is that ek to hai ki, you know, jo tractor hai ya commercial vehicle hai, it is following a certain pattern of buying. So ek bar wo thoda sa purana ho jata hai, they don't run it for like 10 years the way we run cars for 10 years, you know, like our personal vehicles. But having said that, one thing which is happening is that this demand comes back every 2-3 years for the commercial vehicles. And for tractors, of course, it is dependent on a season that plays out. So we have better season, better crop output. Naturally, that goes up. The other very interesting thing for all of you is, see, the government is also doing a lot of work in this space. So indirectly, they're not really saying that, okay, go and buy more tractors. But what they are saying is that we want to increase the farmers' income. Every single budget without fail talks about this, that we want to increase the income of farmers. The MSP, the minimum support price for the goods that are being produced by the farmer is getting a re-rating each time. The government buys it at a certain rate, so the farmer benefits, his income goes up. Not only that, there is also private sector participation as well as government emphasis on direct to farmers. So we can see, you know, farmers are coming, you know, right in front of us is happening. Farmers are coming in our locality and they're selling their produces. And in that sense, even larger companies, I mean, ITC for a fact, I know, is actually putting a lot of effort and resources to procure directly from the farmer, elimination of middlemen. So there's better value for the consumer. And of course, there's better income for the farmer. So if farmer ka income upar jayega, then naturally his consumption of, his need to develop and cultivate will go up. And at the same time, you know, the demand for commercial and industrial transportation also sort of moves up.